Hello everyone, welcome to the maths class. You all know that we are doing chapter 4, simple equation, right? So in our today's class, we are going to start from question number 3 from exercise 4.4. But before that, I have given you assignment in our previous class, right? We will solve that first and we'll proceed to our question number 3, alright? Student, here we have our question as a home assignment 2C from exercise 4.4. This question is, Sachin scored twice as many as Rahul. Okay, together their runs fell two short of a double century. How many runs did each one score? That you have to find. Okay, so Sachin scored twice as many as Rahul. So Sachin is scoring twice of that of Rahul. So let the runs scored by Rahul be X. Okay, first of all, the Rahul is making X run, then Sachin is scoring twice of that of Rahul. Okay, so runs scored by Sachin according to the question is 2X, twice of that of Rahul, so 2 into X. So together their run falls too short. Okay, so whenever we count them together, then it will be X plus 2X, right? Together the runs fell too short of the double century, and we will write here. The question over here is, runs fell too short means to reach double century, they were less by 2 runs. Okay, they did not reach double century. Too short means 2 runs were less to reach the double century. Okay, so we can write X plus 2X is 3X. And 200 minus 2 is 198. Student, I hope you have understood. Just read the question properly. Together their run, that is X plus 2X, together their run means Sachin run and Rahul run, that is Rahul run and Sachin run, plus together run fell too short of 2 means this 2 here. 2 short means minus double century means, doubles in cricket, century means 100. Double century means 200. Okay, this term should be clear to you to solve the problem. Double century, to reach that, they were too short. That means they did not reach double century by 2 runs, that is minus 2. Here it is my 198. So X is equal to 198 by 2. So when you calculate this, sorry, over here it is 3. When you calculate this, it is 66. 36 are 18, 1 in hand and 36 are 18. Okay, so Rahul, how much run Rahul has scored? Therefore Rahul is X, so it is 66 run, and Sachin scored how much? Twice of Rahul, that is 2 into 66 is equal to 132 runs. Okay, I hope this is clear to you all. So this was all as our home assignment. So now we will proceed to our class assignment. Okay, so student, here we have the question number 3 from exercise 4.4. this will be a class assignment. Okay, so here we have the part 1 question. The question says that Irfan says that he has 7 marble, more than 5 times the marble Parmeet has. Irfan has 37 marbles. How many marbles does Parmeet have? Okay, so this sum was done in the previous class. I hope you remember. If you go back to the previous exercise, you will find this question. We have formed the equation at that time. We didn't solve, but in this video, we are going to form the equation as well as we will solve the problem also. Okay, so how many marble does Parmeet have?
The question is this. So let us assume the number of permits marble is M. Okay, we don't know, so we have to find this number. So according to the question, what is the question trying to say is Irfan says that he has 7 marble. Okay, Irfan has 7 marble more than 5 times the permit marble. 5 times the permit marbles permit has. So permit has how many? M marble. Okay, so Irfan has how many? 7 marble more than the 5 times the marble permit has. Okay, and Irfan has total how many? 37 marbles. Okay, Irfan has 7 marbles more than the permit, than 5 times the marbles permit has. Okay, so altogether total number of marble Irfan has was 37. So 5 into m plus 7 is 5m plus 37. I have explained you in the previous class also how to frame the equation. Now what you are going to do? 37 minus 7, transposing 5m is equal to 30. Now m is equal to 30 by 5 is 6. So your answer is, so you can write permit has 6 marbles. Alright, so I hope this is clear to you. So just try to understand the question, frame the equation and solve it. It is just as simple as that. Okay. Okay student, proceeding forward to part 2 from question number 3 of exercise 4.4. The question state that Lakshmi's father is 49 years old. Lakshmi's father is 49 years old. He is 4 years older than 3 times Lakshmi's age. What is Lakshmi's age? That you have to calculate. Even this sum we have done in the previous exercise, if you remember. So what we have to find? Lakshmi's age. So let the Lakshmi's age be, say, y years. Let us take new term, that is new variable, that is y. Okay, y years old. So according to the question, what we can write? Lakshmi father is 49 years old. Okay, he is 4 years older than 3 times Lakshmi's age. That means 3 times the Lakshmi's age means it is y, and plus 4 years older also. That is, total age of the Lakshmi's father is 49. Now we have to find the value of y, that is your Lakshmi's age. Okay. So 3 into y is 3y plus 4 is equal to 49. Now 3y is equal to 49 minus 4. This will come here and become minus 4. And y is equal to 49 minus 4 is how much? 45. By 3 we can write 3 into y. And 3 1s are 3, 3 15s. So therefore we can write Lakshmi is 15 years old. Lakshmi age is 15 years and that of his father is 49 years. So Lakshmi father is 49 years old. He is, Lakshmi's father is 4 years older, that means plus 4, then 3 times the Lakshmi's age. So this makes your equation, and by solving that we got our Lakshmi's age, that is 15 years old. I hope you have understood this. Proceeding forward to our last question, that is part 3 from question number 3. The question is, people of Sundargram planted trees in a village garden. Okay, some of the trees were fruit trees. The number of the non-fruit trees were 2 more than 3 times the number of fruit trees. What was the number of the fruit trees planted if the number of non-fruit trees planted was 77? So there were 2 trees, that was fruit trees and non-fruit trees. Okay, So according to the question, some of the trees were fruit trees. The number of the non-fruit trees, number of the non-fruit trees were 2 more, okay, than 3 times the number of fruit trees. What was the number of the fruit trees planted if the total number of the fruit non-fruit trees was 77? So this is all about the equation. So but before that, we will write few things which is very very mandatory. The number, let the number of the fruit trees be F. Okay, let the number of the fruit trees be F. And according to the question, the number of the non-fruit trees was two more than the three times the number of fruit trees. That is, your fruit trees is F, so 3 times the fruit trees plus 2 more than the fruit trees. That is, altogether non-fruit trees planted was 77. Okay, so now when you calculate this, from the we can get our number of fruit trees, right? So 3F is equal to 77 minus 2. 3F is equal to 75. Now when you divide this, F is equal to 75 divided by 3 is 25. So what you can write here? Therefore, number of fruit tree was 25. Okay, I hope you have understood. Just read the question properly, go through it and try to frame equation, and then easily you can solve it. Okay student, here we have the question number 4 from exercise 4.4. we are over with question number 3. I hope you have understood. Just practice a lot, okay, so that you will be in a form to solve every questions. Okay, so here we have question number 4. This is the last question from our exercise with the chapter, I mean to say. Okay, so let us solve this also. Solve the following riddle. Okay, this is one phrase given which has got many meanings. You have to solve the meaning. You have to use that every meaning given over here, and you have to get the value. Okay, just see. I am a number. Tell my identity. Take me 7 times over and add a 50. To reach a triple century, you still need 40. It's very easy. Just you have to understand the thing. Okay, I am a number. So we don't know what is that number. So we are going to do this thing, that the main thing which we are doing from the beginning onwards, that is, let the number be, say, X. Okay, let the number be X. Tell my identity, take me. So you have to assume that X as 7 times over and add a 50. You have to add a 50. 7 times means 7 into X. No, 7 into X is makes you 7 times with that of number. Add 50 to reach a triple century. That means you have to reach a triple century. I have already said you in a Sachin and Rahul case that century means 100. Over here it is triple. Triple means 300. Okay, triple means 300. To reach 300, you still need how much? 40. What you have to do? You have to add 40. Right? I hope you have understood this. Now, you add this number, bring to the right hand side, get the X value. Okay? If you have not understood, you can comment me. If you have understood and if you have got the answer, if you are able to do, just show me in the comment section. Okay? And the question must be done. Okay? So student, I hope you will do this. With this, we are over with our question. The every question given in the exercise from the chapter, we are over. In our next class, we will do our next chapter. Okay, so see you in the next class. Till then, stay safe and healthy, and do not forget to practice. Okay, thank you everyone.